Okay, and it's just after 8:32, and let's say a big welcome to Dan Clews. Hello, Dan.
Hello, Dave.
How you doing?
Very well, thank you.
Good. Listen, I've got to tell you, I was reading your biography, as one does, you know, and I thought to myself, well, if people are into country music, they go to Nashville. If they want to get into shows, they go to New York. They want West Coast, they go to California. You took off to Sweden. Why?
Well, funnily enough, Sweden are some of the biggest hitters in the whole of Europe in terms of music production. I think they're the third biggest music exporter in the world, second to the UK and America. So, yeah, I guess it was just the music. They got some fabulous musicians out there, but I've just found myself a band that cut it just as well, or in fact better, over here in Kent. I've got them all in the studio right now.
Oh, nice one. Hello, band.
Hello, band.
A little squeaky, but yes, I get the picture. Now, you are from Kent, yeah, originally. The man from Strawberry Fields. Now, why are you linked to strawberries, and why don't I have a big box here?
I'll send you one in. It's strawberry season right now, actually, here at Stonefield Farm in Seven Oaks. So, yeah, my family's always been farmers, strawberry farmers, and we are now one of the last remaining traditional fruit farmers in the county. We still store up our straw between our strawberries, and we don't do polytunnels. We do it the old way.
Those polytunnels, to me, there's something about them. I don't know. I know that they're good for growing things and everything, but when I see a field that's full of polytunnels, I go,
oh, well, yeah, exactly. Needs must, but we do it a different way.
Yeah. Now, tell me about your association with George Martin, because we were associated with him for quite some years with a certain radio station in London, which he was a director of, and got to know him quite well. He did our first set of jingles and everything. And I was like, wow, the Beatles producer. I could never quite get over that. How did you get along with them?
Well, I think, as you probably know, he's always supported new and fresh music, and even to this day, he's still supporting new and fresh music. And that's how it happened. He stumbled upon us as far as manager, and me, in fact, my music. It's been a kind of ongoing working relationship for a few years now, and one of the best honours I've had in my career.
Yes, he is. He's a most lovely fellow, isn't he?
Because absolute gentleman.
He was a director of that radio station in London, and he used to come up to us when we would be working, as we were sometimes pre-launch, 18 hours a day, and then we'd go into the canteen and we'd just flop out on the sofa, you know, and get a few hours sleep, as it were. And he used to come in and he used to say, and really like he meant it, you know, how do you guys do it? This is amazing. Please let me buy you some dinner, you know, this kind of thing. And he'd take us out to the hotel across the street and treat us all. And he is such a genuine man.
Yeah, he is an absolute gentleman.
Yeah. Now, I have to say, I was looking at your YouTube thing, and I saw the video that you have made.
Yeah.
Or That's Enough for Me.
Excellent.
That is brilliant. It is absolutely brilliant.
Oh, that's great. Thank you.
Was that your idea?
Yes, it was, yeah. And an idea that was that sort of helped to come to fruition with a guy called Robin Collins, who helped me direct it, and he produced it. And we between the two of us put together the video that is now up on YouTube. You can find it on my website as well. You go there.
Okay, I don't want to give it away. I don't want to talk about it because people should go and see it.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, because if we talk about it, it's going to spoil the whole thing.
It's one of those things, you need to see it from start to finish. And then you get the twist at the end.
I got to admit, you're very handy with a pair of scissors. That's all I'm going to say. Now,
a lot of practice.
Where can they see all this your video? Because it's well worth the trip.
Well, if you go to my website, which is www.dan Clews, and I'm going to spell my second name because it always comes up. It's Charlie Lima Esco Whiskey Sugar Clews. So danclews.com, and you'll find it there on the front page. I've always struggled with that second name.
No, I know. Especially with Martin around, you know what I mean?
Well, actually, my dad is, funny enough, called Martin Clews.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
God. Well, I do. I had such a good laugh at that this afternoon because it came in, and I said they, you know, showed me that it was up there. So I said, oh, must have a look. And I just cracked up. I thought that was so clever.
And, no, and thank you very much.
Oh, the song, that's enough for me. Is it coming out as a single?
It will be coming out as a single. It'll definitely be one of the singles from the forthcoming record. We're kind of still at the stages of negotiating all the you know, the release plan and everything. But it will be coming out. We're just sitting on it and making sure we don't just throw it out there at the wrong time. But yeah, that will be coming out. And the best way to see it now is to go and find the YouTube video.
Yeah, well, it's well worth it. I mean, the song is very good. It's excellent anyway. But the video that goes with it. Oh, wow. Yeah. Okay, can I ask you one sneaky question? What kind of motorbike was it?
That's a good question. It's a definite Triumph, and I keep calling it a Bantam, but I don't know the actual make of it. If you're on Twitter, I'll sort of tweet it to you. I can't quite remember what the model was.
Okay.
Call me out there.
No, I'm not going to say anymore because I'll mess it up if I do.
Yeah.
Okay. And is there any place, Dan, that people can see you live? Are you performing at all?
Yeah, I'll be performing tomorrow, in fact, at the Grey Lady with my band as a warm-up to our big show, which is on the weekend. We're playing at the Hop Farm Festival, and we're playing at 1:35 on the Bread and Roses stage. So if you're heading
excellent,
over there.
Excellent, excellent. And tomorrow, Wednesday the 27th, you're at the Grey Lady Music Lounge in Tunbridge Wells.
That's right, yeah.
Okay. Well, the Hop Farm, I know. I go by it twice a day when I go home and come to work. And there's lots of, there's so much construction going on there. It's going to be quite a festival this time, isn't it?
It's going to be a good party, and the best place to be is 1:35 on the Bread and Roses stage on Saturday.
Yeah, that's the one. Okay, I'm going to play That's Enough for Me without the video, but I'm going to have a sort of look at it.
And you reenact it in the studio.
Yeah, bring me the mic. Brett, bring me the mic. Thank you. I wish. Okay, Dan, best of luck for the weekend and for tomorrow night as well, and the best of luck with the record as well.
Thank you, Dave.
Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Cheers.
I was blinded by the light. I was holding out for the key. Looking for the people, and the people were looking for me. And I like, and I do, but I don't know what I am. What are you? What are you? Over my shoe, I'm a bubble in a bubble. I haven't got a clue. I was looking for direction. My compass is a little askew. Instead of going around, I was looking for a route straight through. And I like, and I do, but I don't know what I am. What are you? What are you? Looks like I put this puzzle together. Not easy when you're in so many pieces, but I know my heart is there, and that's enough for me. I was looking for the answer, and I got a little confused. My hands hold water like my hands can hold the truth. I was on the mind, disregarded, the only one who didn't get the punchline buried deep inside. The payout for my sports was dead. I'm alive, and I do, but I don't know what I am. What are you? What are you? Looks like I put this puzzle together in the wrong order somehow. Looks like these letters form words that I can't read. But I know my heart is here, and that's enough for me. And I do, but I don't know what I am. What are you? What are you? What a year it's been. But I'm no closer to pinning down what it is that is me. Looks like I put this puzzle together in the wrong order somehow. Looks like these letters fall words that I can read. I'm down to tea, not easy when you're in so many pieces. But I know my heart is here and that's enough for me.
Yeah, Dan Clews, and That's Enough For Me from his forthcoming album. And if you'd like to see him live, he'll be tomorrow at the Grey Lady Music Lounge in Tunbridge Wells. And then on Saturday, he'll be at the Hop Farm in Paddock.